Okay, today the topic of our practical classes is tumors. The general information about the tumors that we call as the neoplasia. Okay, so what means the neoplasia? The new growth or the new mass. So the neoplastic process, they have the some morphological features such as the autonomy of the tumor cells to grow, the independence of controls, atypia, some cataplasia and anaplastic features. So here you see the statistics of the tumor processes that mostly in the man, the prostate cancer prevail, and the breast cancer in the humans and other cancers. What means like atypia? Atypia, atypia, not typical. Yep, this is the pathologic term of the structural, functional, and metabolic and other abnormalities. There are some types of the atypia, the morphological, functional, biochemical, and antigenic. As the pathomorphologist, pathohistologist, we may mostly interested in the morphological atypia. This is the structural differences of tumor cells from the originating normal cells. There are cytological atypia, high, and the cellular atypia. So the tissue atypia and the cellular atypia. Some features of the cellular atypia include the pleomorphism. We call it the polymorphism in Russian, pleomorphism. It means that the changing of the shape of the nucleus and the size of the nucleus, the altered nucleocytoplasmic rupture, the hyperchromic and pleomorphic nuclei, pathologic mitosis, and others. But the histological atypia, it includes the destroying of the character or distortion of the characteristic structure of the tissue. Types of the antigenic atypia include the antigens by tumors induced by viruses, such as the human papilloma viruses, Epstein-Barr viruses, antigen of tumors induced by cancerogenic substances, transplantation type antigens, embryonic antigens, or the oncofetal antigens, and heteroorgan antigens. What means the anaplasia? Anaplasia, it means that to go to backward, to obtain the features characteristic for the mother tissue. This include the pure cellular differentiation, the loss of the morphological characteristic of the mature cells, losing their orientation with respect to each other and to endothelial cells, the nuclear pleomorphism, we discussed it, altered nuclear cytoplasmic rupture, presence of the nucleoli, high proliferation index, or the mitotic activity. In the neoplastic process, during the characterizing the tumors, we use the some grading systems. So the classification of tumors according to their differentiation. There are well differentiated, moderately differentiated, pure differentiated, and undifferentiated, or the anaplastic tumors. So the well differentiated tumors, it means that the cells are very similar in appearance and architectural arrangement to normal tissue. Moderately differentiated cancer cells, they look and behave somewhere between well differentiated and undifferentiated cancer cells. That most types of the cancers have the moderately differentiated. For example, here we see the benign tumor of the colon, we call the adenoma. So the adenoma similar to the normal structure of the colon, but it doesn't mean that the all the benign tumors has the well differentiated. The malignant tumor also have the well differentiated grading, a pure differentiated. It means that the tumors show only minimal resemblance to the normal parent tissue they are derived from. But anaplastic, it means that it's underpredicated. There is no abelian similarity to this parent tissue, usually associated with the aggressive behavior. But differentiation often provides the clues to the clinical aggressiveness of the tumor. So when we said that well differentiated, it is so they have the so good prognosis. But the tumors with the pure differentiation, they have the bad prognosis. Here you see the tumor with the moderately, here we see the well differentiated adenocarcinoma. You see the well differentiated adenocarcinoma. This is the tumor of the glandular tissue, glandular epithelial tissue. Here we see we do the moderately differentiated adenocarcinoma. You see the we can found here the glandular structure as well, and at the same time the single tumor cells that invaded to the stroma. Here is the pure differentiated adenocarcinoma, you see, and undifferentiated adenocarcinoma. This is the medullary carcinoma that they have no any resemblance to the parent tissue. Some microscopic features of the tumors. Here we said that is the loss of the normal architectural arrangement. This is the histological ATPR. This is the skin tumor, the squamous carcinoma of the skin, the gross view, and we see the histologically, in one side, there is the normal structure of the epithelial tissue, and here we see the development of the tumor. And under the microscopy, we found the very aggressive, very malignant tumor cells here. As we said, the pleomorphism, the one of the features of the cellular ATPR. Here we see we do the so big, bizarre cells with the abnormal nucleus that they defragmentated, hyperchromic. Also, another feature is the pathologic mitosis, the mitotic activity. They increase in the malignant tumor. And they mostly they have the abnormal shape. About the cause of the cancer, I will pass this one briefly. I will say that there are some environmental factors, the aging, the specific geographic zones, the professional factors, obesity, and inherited cancer syndromes, such as the radiation, the ionizing radiation, ultraviolet lights, the oncogenic viruses such as the hepatitis viruses, the human papilloma viruses, Epstein-Barr viruses, then the action of the P53 protein, the normally the P53 protein it controls the cell division. When the during the cell cycle present some any damage of the DNA or some any abnormalities, hypoxia, the P53 protein arrests the cell cycle, repair the DNA, and they restart the cell cycle. And also, it can trigger the apoptosis, that the cell must go to the base. But when the P53 protein damage in the cells, after this one, the damages the cell with the damaged DNA or the some abnormalities continue the division, and here forms the malignant tumors. There are some theories of the cancerogenesis, the viral genetic theory of the Zilbers, the psycho, the physico-chemical theory of the Virchow, the ontogenetic theory of the Kornheim, and the polyetiologic theory of the Petrov. Tumor morphogenesis has three periods. first the pre-tumoral conditions such as the atrophy, hyperplasia, sclerosis, chronic inflammation, metaplasia, dysplasia, dishormonal processes, metabolic disorders, and these precancerogenic processes subdivided into two groups: obligatory, the absolute, and facultative or relative. And tumor formation to the second period of the tumor morphogenesis. First, the initiation or the mutation period, mutation in the genetic apparatus of the cell, and expression or the modification period that include the proliferation, malignization, autonomic growth of the cells. And the tumor growth patterns, rather expansive, invasive, and the oppositional patterns. The expansive pattern, it is the that means that peritumoral tissues are compressed and the capsule around the tumor is formed here. They're usually characteristic for the benign tumors. But the invasive pattern, it includes that the tumor invade to surrounding tissue. There is no any capsule around the tumor, usually characteristic for the malignant tumors. And the oppositional, the mutagenic effect of the tumor cells to normal cells is caused by the tumor transformation. But in our body, there is the hollow organs or the cavitary organs. Yeah, according to this lumen of these organs, there are two types of the growth patterns. First, the exophytic and the endophytic. Exophytic, it means that the tumor grows expansively toward the lumen. But the endophytic, the tumor grows invasively into the wall of the hollow organ. So that the wall organ, the wall of the organ is thickened. I will try to show you by samples. Here you see the benign tumor that's surrounded with the capsule, and this is the expansive growth pattern. But here we see we do the breast cancer, the malignant tumor of the mammary gland, and here we see the gross view of the breast cancer, the term of the cancer taken from this tumor, because it has the crab-like, the cancer view. And this microscopic figure of the invasive growth pattern. So the periods of the tumor morphogenesis has the destroying of the regeneration, appearance of the hyperplasia, dysplasia, the malignization, proliferation, formation of the tumor bud, and the progression. So now let's discuss about the clinical morphological classification of the tumors that we classified as the benign tumors, malignant tumors, and the carcinoma in situ. Benign, it typically refers to those tumors that incapable for metastasis and having a good clinical prognosis. But malignant, this tumor have the ability to invasive growth or the metastasis, and often is fatal if not treated effectively. Here we see the comparison between the benign and the malignant tumors. The benign tumors, they have the circumscribed, often encapsulated, that push the normal tissue aside. And here we see the malignant tumor that had infiltrated growth, no any capsule, and they destruct the normal tissues. And here also we see we do the adenoma, colonic adenoma. We call this the tubular adenoma, the gross view and the microscopic view. That the microscopically it is no any differences between, not such differences between the normal tissue. But here we see the colonic adenocarcinoma, the cancer of the colon. That here you see the development of the malignant tumor with the necrotic hemorrhagic areas and the microscopy of the colonic adenocarcinoma. So the differences between the benign and malignant cells, let me summarize that in the benign tumors, the nuclear variation in size and the shape minimal, and the malignant tumor, the nuclear variation in size and shape minimal to severe, to marked, often variable. So the, in the benign tumors, they have the diploid chromosome number and the malignant tumor range of diploidy. In the benign tumors, the low mitotic count, the normal mitosis appears. In the malignant tumors, they are the, there is a low to high mitotic count, abnormal mitosis. And the retention of the specialization in the benign tumor and the loss of the specialization in the malignant tumor. In the benign tumor, there is the structural differentiation retained, but the malignant tumor, the structural differentiation shows the wide range of the change. And so the benign tumor is organized, they have the capsule, the malignant tumor not organized, and in non-benign tumor, they have the functional differentiation usually, and the functional differentiation often lost in the malignant tumor. And here also we see the malignant versus the benign tumors, schematic diagram. And tumor spread, how the tumors are spread. The tumor spread is a characteristic for the malignant tumor. Usually the benign tumors, they not spread. They have the local invasion and metastasis. Local invasion, and the malignant tumors, says they invade, penetrate the adjacent, the local tissue. But the metastasis means that spread the malignant tumor from the one side to another via the blood or lymph. So there is the lymphatic metastasis, the hematogenic metastasis, contact or the implantation metastasis, and mixed metastasis. According to the direction of the metastasis, there is the ortograde, retrograde, there are the ortograde, retrograde, and paradoxal metastasis. Ortograde, it means that toward the blood flow or the lymph flow, retrograde against the lymph or the blood flow. The lymphatic metastasis, this is commonly for the cancers, as the tumor of the carcinomas, the tumor of the epithelial tissue we call as the cancers. So for example, in the regional lymph nodes, we can find the metastasis. This is here you see the lymph nodes, that is the subcapsular sinuses, and here we see with you the metastasis of the carcinoma. Or the lymphatic metastasis, they can reach the distant lymph nodes. Hematogenous metastasis, the typical for the sarcoma. Sarcoma, this is the malignant tumors of the connective tissue. So they invade the wall of the blood vessels and enter the blood flow. For example, from the portal vein system, they can reach the liver. From the systemic base, they can reach the lung. From the pulmonary vein system, they can reach the other organs. Here, there is the follicular thyroid carcinoma vascular invasion. You see here the section of the blood vessels that with the malignant tumor cells. We also use the TNM classification. TNM, tumor nodes metastasis. The tumor is show the size of the tumor. For example, TX is unable to assess the primary tumor. T0, no evidence of primary tumor. TIC, carcinoma in situ. T1, solitary tumor without the vascular invasion. T2, solitary tumor with vascular invasion. I will say that this is the change. This change by the organs. For example, in the salivary glands, in the stomach, in the intestines, they change. Mainly, they show that the invading of the tumor to the layers of the mucosa, submucosa, muscular layer, serosa, and nodes. We take the assessment of the regional, the present of the invasion in the regional and the non-regional lymph nodes, and the metastasis, present of the distant metastasis. So we summarize the stage of the cancer stage. The cancer stage depended on the cancer grade. Okay. For example, when we said that T10N0M0, it is the first stage. With the T2, it is the second stage. T through A, stage 3A, and etc. So stage zero, it means that carcinoma in situ. It means that this cancer, they limited in the epithelial tissue and they not spread. stage 1, 2, 3, this higher stage of the cancer that correspond to the large tumors and the great extent of disease. And the stage 4, this is the final stage. This cancer that has spread to distant lymph nodes, tissues, or organs. Let me discuss about the carcinoma in situ. This is the epithelial neoplasm with features of malignancy that they characterize the altered cell growth, the cytological atypia with histologic atypia, altered differentiation, and microscopically appears at the malignant tumors, but no invasion through the basement membrane, and they don't metastasis. You pay attention here. This is the cervix, uterine cervix, and carcinoma in situ, cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, third grade. And here we can find the increasing of the nuclear size and the mitotic activity. Here we see the pathologic mitosis, but no any invasion. No any invasion through the basement membrane. And there is the common systemic effect of malignant tumors, such as the loss of the appetite, cancer cachexia, we discussed with you in the general pathological atrophy, fever in the some lymphomas, general fatigue, anemia, pain, and muscular weakness. But there are the secondary changes in the tumor tissue. In the benign tumor, they include the inflammation, mucinosis, and calcinosis. In malignant tumors, mainly there we can find the necrosis and the foci of the hemorrhage. And the classification of the neoplasm tumors. We can classify the epithelial tumors without a specific localization, specific localized or organ-specific epithelial tumors that now we'll discuss about the cancer or the next classes about the gastric cancer, lung cancer, colorectal cancer, then mesenchymal tumor, or another way we can call as the soft tissue and bone tumors, the tumors of the melanophimic tissue, tumors of the nervous tissue and brain, tumors of the hemopoietic and the lymphoid tissue, and the teratomas, the germ cell tumors. So we finished our today classes about the general information of the tumors. Have you any questions? Okay, let's finish our classes.